We are back with the closeout of the first pod of GFC. Now, again, this is the playoff match, round three. We're taking a look at Wonka versus Blunt today. These are two absolute powerhouses that both came in second in their respective groups. Wonka won his group. Excuse me. I apologize. Wonka won his group. Blunt came in second only to JPEG, who just blew the scorecard out of the water. I'm very excited for this match. This is going to be a concept barrage. And it's a good thing that our guest judge, Mirage, is from Concept Creators. But,
all three of the judges here are on Concept
Creators. Oh, yeah, that's right. Yeah, that's... I'm sorry.
Just
excuse me.
You're wondering.
Yeah, that's
one
right.
One of
I'm
us
sorry,
is the, actually captain, a captain.
And Recursion is one of the newest members. This is kind of like a CC squad right here.
This is absolutely the CC judging panel, Illuminati. Just so you know,
Les and I are over here just like dee-dee-dee-dee.
If you have a favorite Glover, chances are they probably have the CC tag. I'm just saying. Probably.
Or our alumni, they're somewhere in that list.
Or alumni, that's they're on the list. Chances are. It's always exceptions to the rule. Good odds.
On that note,
favorite Glover's on CC.
Yeah, your favorite Glover is in fact on CC. That is a quantifiable.
Yep.
How's it physic?
Yeah, Sam's the only one who's not.
Okay, but physic is like the ideal of CC.
Physic is like the avatar of CC, even if he's not on CC. He's like right. What CC.
He's like the mask of morphing.
It's like CC is like the shrine that was built to physic. That's what CC is.
Absolutely. Anyway. On that note.
Like.
Let's physically jump into this match and start by taking a look at Wonka.
On the West Coast, they got a saying, if you're not drinking, then you're not playing. But
present example A of light show.
another example, prime example of what he's actually in a really unique scenario because he was student zero of You Got Moves.
Basically,
he was student zero of Two Glove, which if you know your history, you know that's what You Got Moves used to be.
Yeah, he was one of like five students that was like in the first class of like test students for gloving. It was like, hey, we're throwing spaghetti at a wall, so we're gonna like throw everything at you. He's like, oh, okay, and he became the wall.
And he took that spaghetti and he ran with it.
Absolutely.
He's showing off.
Don't run with spaghetti. No,
you should absolutely run with spaghetti. 100% run with spaghetti. He's shown off why he took second in 4KC. He's shown off exactly what it means to not just know the meta, but define the meta.
Trendsetter.
Exactly. Like,
I mean, he has some of those iconic puzzle work.
Exactly. Like, there's just so much to this light show that we could talk about. I'm just gonna let you guys talk for a second because I've already said stuff.
I mean, looking at his complexity, the puzzle work he has, there's a difference between playing with isolation points and tracing them, and then taking those points and
folding them in on themselves.
Exactly, smushing them together, folding them in on, like, you know how you make a croissant, right? You fold in the butter, right? You have to make sure that the layers are all crisp and clean. This croissant was flaky. It was flaky. All right, it was good. This was good. I like this.
Good croissant. Good flake.
Good flake.
The only time when talking about croissants is the only time flaky is a compliment. But damn, was it flaky!
Flaky as shit.
I would say pastries in general are good to be flaky. But yeah, no, you're right. Same page.
The point stands.
Lust, where you at on this?
I mean, I love Wonka's shows, and you know, I've always felt he's always had a little bit of trouble. Really showing off to the camera, but I think he did a pretty good job here using with his depth percentage and things like that. I know there was one move, I don't know.
I know what you're talking about. I know
the way you like traced, this. And traced, he was going traced. Down and out. Yes. You know, those moves I thought could have been placed a little bit better to really see that depth, but I mean, his use of depth overall is just phenomenal, you know. I mean,
his recording quality has increased too.
Musicality. I heard Teddy like gasp at one musicality note, I believe, right?
Yeah, there was a point in the beginning and it was just it was like my only response is something that actually Animated Jay kind of put me onto, is that I saw that you heard that.
Yeah.
And it's basically just an homage to, like, hey, I can tell that you were fully aware of everything going on in the song, and you just, like, effortlessly just, like, you know, whatever, no problem, tossed it in, like, no big deal. It just A1. Absolutely.
He very much
A1.
Told us the story at the very beginning of the show, and it was...
Yeah.
It was...
Real quick,
digestible.
While the judges get their scores in Mirage, any quick thoughts on the show?
I mean, Wonka's always been slaying it. I actually have gotten shows before from both of the contestants in this battle. So I got a show from Wonka, five years ago in Texas, and my man was not as skilled as he is now. See, the growth is, like someone was saying, kid's cracked.
So. He took that spaghetti, bro. He took the spaghetti and he ran off with the spaghetti.
He made spaghetti armor.
He made some fucking meatballs to go with the spaghetti.
Spaghetti Iron Man. He was Iron Man in the cave and took the spaghetti and made it into a suit of armor and came
absolutely
through.
Absolutely.
Iron Man with spaghetti
Iron Man. That's my new favorite. That's my new favorite reference of all time.
Spaghetti Iron Man.
I'm calling Wonka Spaghetti Iron Man from now on. I don't care what happens.
I love it. Okay, so we do have Wonka's scores in, so let's go ahead and pull this guy up real quick. Take a look and see what we got. And Wonka coming in with a 34. Woo! And, I mean, just...
They're self-explanatory.
Yeah, I don't need to say it. We've said it. You know,
I would just like to point out that this is actually Jess's highest score during round three so far for his.
I thought I was being nice already, and everyone who comes next is just like, so you know how you scored that last person really high? Hi.
Yeah, we're definitely going to be introducing some measures in the next round to be announced to alleviate that, just in case this gets a little too close to call, even with guest judges. So
perfect.
I think these numbers are doing pretty good, honestly. I mean, realistically, you've got
points
per category, and then you've also got the tiebreaker, and we haven't even given anybody a full score. There's, at the best, these best shows have gotten one full score out of three possible full scores. There's room.
Oh yeah, no, there's definitely room.
Room for growth.
There's definitely room, but I don't like riding the edge too much. You know what I mean? So.
I think what Teddy's getting at is that the darts. I don't think we're not changing the dart board. We're just making the darts a little smaller.
Exactly. We'll figure out the best way to do it. I'm sure there's an easy solution that we can come up with. But while we figure that out, before we figure that out, let's take a look at the second half of this match, and bring in a man who absolutely just murdered his group. Right alongside JPEG, who came in and said, "Me too." Let's take a look at Blunt.
I'm so glad he picked this track, because the drip is fucking real.
Les, you want to start off the conversation on that light show?
Yeah, I mean, just like Jess said, this track, you know, it's definitely hasn't been very popular during this competition, at least in the matches that I've seen. And it's definitely a chill feel to a light show compared to some of these more like high energy shows, right? So how do you think his, you know, cleanliness concepts translated, Kirchen, with this, you know, kind of a slower pace, more like emotional show almost?
You know, it's almost like I need a graph to show you, because like it's almost like he changes the weight of what he relies on for what portion of the song and the show that he's in, right? So, like, in the beginning, it's much more musicality-based, heavy musicality. Very simple on the concepts, but then it starts to go into more complexity, where you have more difficult finger dexterity while still maintaining that musicality. And then he just dives into this cacophony of just beautiful tracers and intricate pathways he was taking with his digits and the scale work too. I mean, all of it was just so well put together. It was mesmerizing, really.
Yeah, Jess, can you talk a little bit about that musicality? I've always thought that, you know, there's musicality where it's almost a little easier if you do more simplistic movements. And later in this show, I saw him like holding his hand, and he hit like four beats like back to back like really quickly, and I was like, wow, that's some, you know, impressive finger dexterity matched up with that musicality. So how did you feel about the musicality?
He knew he had everything pre-planned in this. Clearly, he did his homework. Everything from the aesthetics to the location, to the lighting, to the fat blunt graffitied on the wall behind him. I mean, he set up the subtlety of his musicality in the aesthetics of the show even before he did a single move. And that's what he's really known for, in my mind. He's known for is just absolute mastery through subtlety. And that's what he came through with. And he made me gasp a couple of times because he was folding concepts in on himself over and over and over again, perfectly, on the grid. And then, like you said, there was a couple of different times where he was listening perfectly. As Teddy said, animated Jay said, I saw you hear that, right? Was that what it, yes. was that what it was?
That's, yeah, I saw you heard that. I
saw you heard that.
Or I saw you hear that. That works too. It's same kind of, yeah.
I saw you I like heard that. And you made me hear it, you know? All those
you made me hear that. I like stuff. I almost like that better. Yeah. You made me hear that. Because that's what he did, is he listened for those intricacies, and then he displayed them with his dexterity. And like Adam said, like, he absolutely, you could show it on a time graph, mm-hmm. of how he, but it would be like a,
you'd have like
exponential
six,
curve. It would be like an exponential
six different,
curve.
Six different lines that are like colored differently, just like going their direction for which way is weighted more.
This looks like a close call. This looks like,
yeah, I'm
excited to see how this one turns out. And
I gotta say, Mirage, thoughts on this match while Jest and Recursion ponder their existences and give Blunt a score?
I mean, Blunt slayed it, dude. Like, that's not an easy song to hit those kinds of beats to. Like, that's like an expert on Guitar Hero. That's not an easy fucking track to glove to. He did some cool ass shit to it. It was very effortless on his part. It looked like it was butter, you know? So I'm glad
it looks
I don't
like
have
it's to up
touch
to you
it,
just
hopefully.
To decide.
And Wonka and Blunt, they're both nasty.
Both of them, like, looks like it's up to you to decide.
Well, just kind of let the cat out of the bag, even though you're not supposed to do that.
I think Jess and I both saw what happened, and then we both looked at each other. We're just like,
sorry to cut you off there, Mirage, but I'm going to go ahead and display the scores because it looks like we have a tie between Wonka and Blunt, which means that you have the floor to think out and in your own criteria, as we accept your knowledge as either fact or common understanding within
light shows.
Your word
is final. You are judge, jury, and executioner in this instance.
You are judge, jury, and executioner.
So tell us in detail what you thought of both light shows against each other. And at the end of it, please choose a winner.
All right, I'm just going to have to go in chronological order then so I can keep the thoughts.
That's fine. Do it. Take your time. Floor is yours. You know, do it however you want to.
Wonka had a great intro. Listen to the lyrics, like, nailed the miming, you know, acting out, like, Teddy and Jester pining over. Like, he showed me that he heard that. That was really cool. He's got a big bag of tricks all over the place, multiple kinds of concepts. Has a good blend of that scorecard style show where you're kind of showcasing tricks versus, like, your classic just mind-melting festival show. And I, again, having watched both these people before, I've seen Wonka's growth over the years. So it's really good to see that still in action. Blunt, insane musicality for a very difficult track. Very intriguing and personable concepts. Like, I've seen his bag of tricks grow over the years as well, and they have his flavor to it.
Unique.
Yeah, he's got damn good control of a light, you know? Me and Loki talk about this, and there are speeds at which you can move a light when you're giving a light show to create those different effects, and Blunt understands that control very well of when he's moving his hand, what that image is going to look like, and it's just eye candy. I'm very upset that you guys left this to me.
That's what you're here for, bud.
Thank you.
Who wins?
Just off those two shows, and I'm going to look at it as which show I'd rather receive in person. I'm going to go with Blunt on this one. I think Blunt would have melted my face. So, Wonka still did a great show, but I'm gonna have to give it up to my boy Blunt on this one.
All right. And with that, Blunt moves on and closes it out. So we have... Let me just pull up this bracket one more time.
That match right there, if I can just say one more thing, that match right there shoulda, coulda, woulda been the final match. It really could have. So, GG's to Wonka and GG's to Blunt. Both of you guys showed
nasty
the fuck up.
Nasty shows, gentlemen. Nasty fucking shows.
All the way around.
And now we have our first semifinal pod match, which is Bear versus Geometric versus Blunt in a three-way battle for a single grand finals spot.
That's going to be crazy.
Gnarly.
Take away their finger touch as a challenge.
Anyway, I want to once again thank everybody, our CC panel of judges, Just, Recursion, and Mirage, and my wonderful co-host, Lust. Please
I can't tell which direction is the correct direction. Please, I'm not going to lie to you right now.
Please like, comment, subscribe. And,
you're definitely wrong on my camera. There you go.
We're going with it, okay.
Please, yeah, again, please like, comment, subscribe, tell us what you thought, give us your insight, be part of the conversation, let's get something going. Want to hear from you guys, and we appreciate every single one of you checking us out, so thanks again. We'll be back.
I guess in your content too on TikTok.
Oh, absolutely, yes, please tag
YGM official.
Please tag us on TikTok at YGM Online.
Did I get the wrong?
You did. You said official, Mr. Marketing Director.
Yeah, I thought it was official. It ain't official. Apparently, we're not official.
No, it's that's online. It's online.
YGM
it's
official,
online.
But we're online.
Yeah.
We're officially online.
Yeah, no, but anyway. Thank you again to everybody. Please, again, comment, like, subscribe, and join us for the rest of round three as we try to figure out who else will be joining Bear, Geometric, and Blunt in the semifinals of the GFC.
I'm glad I don't have to judge any of that.
Well, you do have to judge the semifinals.
That's true.
Don't lie, you love it.
Yikes.
We'll see you guys later. Thanks again. Just